Hello everyone, my name is Bruno Benigno from Brazil, a urologist. It's a pleasure and an honor to have here Dr. Alicia Morgan. So she is a medical director of a survivorship program at the Dana-Farber Hospital in Boston. And Dr. Morgan yesterday talked about the new advances in metastatic treatment of prostate cancer and in patients that we need to decide what is the best pathway and how to decide the best treatment for each patient, adapting for their individual characteristics. So I would like to know, Dr. Morgan, what is your thoughts about how do you select the right treatment for each patient with metastatic hormone-sensitive prostate cancer? Thank you for your kind acceptance. Thank you.
Yes, of course. Well, sounds like a very easy question to ask and to answer, but I think these are some of the most complicated decisions that we make. And the first most important thing is that we select our treatments with our patients for hormone-sensitive metastatic disease, and that these shared decisions are really a critical part of not only ensuring that the patient gets the right treatment for him, but also ensuring the doctor-patient relationship is strengthened and maintained, and that we can move forward as a partnership team from this first line of therapy and hopefully through all the subsequent lines of the therapy. We certainly consider the patient characteristics, meaning the comorbidities, the fitness, other medications the patient is on, the patient preferences and beliefs, wishes and thoughts around obligations that may be personal or preferences around certain treatment types or delivery styles. And we consider the disease clinical characteristics, the volume of disease, the aggressiveness of the disease, the distribution. And we have to also, I think, consider our physician characteristics, what we feel comfortable with, what our habits and our tendencies are, because these, whether consciously or subconsciously, will always affect that shared decision as well. So these are also important, as are the specific aspects of the different treatments that we have to offer.
Absolutely. This is for sure a multidisciplinary teamwork, for sure. And more technically, so we know that a lot of advances have been appearing in this scenario, especially trying to select biological characteristics that will guide us to decide who's going to be intensified or de-intensified in this kind of treatment. And what do you see the new biological and molecular advances, particularly in the CTCs and novel tests, imaging tests like PET PSMA, how could we integrate in our practice? And if you are doing this in your center of excellence?
Well, certainly, as you mentioned, PSMA PET is helping to identify patients who are actually metastatic at baseline, rather than being maybe high-risk localized or very high-risk localized disease. So understanding this new population of minimally metastatic disease that is only metastatic on PSMA PET is a prognostic marker that we still have to evaluate. And I would presume that they have a better disease characteristic than perhaps a high volume de novo metastatic patient who is identified on conventional imaging, but this is something that we are investigating. I think other exciting avenues and opportunities include the Artera MMAI molecular profiling, which at present can help us with prognostic implications, so understanding at baseline who has most aggressive or less aggressive disease. But none of our biomarkers are currently ready to help us predict which treatment will actually be the most useful or which treatments may be not helpful in our patients. And so we are a few steps behind the perfection of biomarkers dictating treatment, other than, I think, with our HRR mutations, particularly BRCA1, BRCA2, for our PARP inhibitor opportunities.
Perfect. And my last point is, you talked about the attrition between lines of treatment, and you gave a number about 50% of patients doesn't go to the next line of treatment. And one way to reduce this attrition is having the genetic information up front.
Yes.
So could you comment on that and your final thoughts, please?
Sure. So genetic testing for metastatic patients in the U.S. at least, and increasingly in other guidelines, it's recommended for all patients with metastatic disease. And this is a germline genetic testing recommendation. Somatic genetic testing also, I think, if we have the opportunity, these are not useful in treatment choice in the metastatic hormone-sensitive setting, but are useful for family member counseling from a germline perspective and may be very useful as we get to the next line. And if we have the information up front and ready to go, we can perhaps get to that next treatment more quickly, which then can reduce the attrition, which on multiple studies seems to be approximately 50% of patients per line who are perhaps having poor performance status, more frail, or passing away before they can get to the next line. So anything we can do to reduce the attrition, I think, is in our best interest, certainly for us and our patients.
Perfect. Thank you very much for you. And thank you for you as well, Dr. Alicia. Have a nice flight back to your home. And nice to meet you in person. Actually, I've been watching you and following your work in Euro Today about, you know, four years. It's amazing, amazing work. And I've learned so much with your thoughts and your interviews. And for me, it's a personal honor to be here with you. Thank you so much.
It is my honor. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Alicia. Bye.